Hello, and we are here at EHA 2019 in Amsterdam. And this afternoon we have Sagar Lonial came by and wanted to share the key information that has come out of both the ASCO conference from a few weeks back as well as the EHA conference this week. There's been a lot of new things that are happening within the myeloma space, and he's here to summarize what are the key takeaways and the key learnings that will shape the practice for the next year or so.
Sagar? Yeah. Thanks, Blake. I think, you know, at ASCO and EHA, we saw things that spread the paradigm across all of myeloma, starting off with smoldering, where at ASCO, there was an update of the IMWG risk stratification model that demonstrated sort of a scoring system that was able to identify high risk, intermediate risk, and low risk patients using routine scoring system and routine criteria that really is very valuable and is an important way to identify the high risk from everybody else.
May I ask a question about that?
Yeah.
Will that also enable better approaches to whether patients need treatment or do they watch and wait? And is that the intent of those new guidelines?
Yeah, the intent is to understand who should be eligible and enrolled on trials. So what we've been able to do is really hone in on the low risk people and say these people, at least right now, their median time to develop myeloma is so long that we shouldn't intervene with those guys. Whereas the intermediate and the high risk, I think you should. Or at least consider them for trials.
Okay.
In the high-risk group, I actually presented data on the randomized ECOG trial of lenalidomide alone versus observation, demonstrating a pretty significant improvement in PFS and a hazard ratio of 0.24 favoring early treatment, which is almost identical to the hazard ratio the Spanish trial from a few years ago showed as well. So at least my conclusion walking out of there is that if you have high-risk smoldering and you're not eligible for a trial or you don't have a trial open, you should really think about getting early treatment because those are patients that have a 50% risk of progression within 2 years.
And this is just single agent lenalidomide?
So it's single agent len or using len with dex as the Spanish group did.
Okay.
I think the goal here is not eradication of the disease as it is with most other plasma cell disorders. The goal here is prevention. Prevent the development of organ damage, prevent the development of myeloma.
Right.